class temp me group for presentation. Consisting of AJIT, AMAT, Dance Who, Subha Sorak, Subjit, Rohan, Sorak, Akash and Asif. Submitted to Manisha Ma'am and Santosh Sir. Welcome to the PowerPoint presentation of Natural Resources in India. Index Resource Development of Resources, Resource Planning. The resource is a source or supply from which benefit is produced. Typically, resources are materials, services, staff, or other assets. Resource planning is the strategy of judicious use of resources to conserve them. It has importance in a country like India, which has enormous diversity in the availability of resources. It is the process of developing the resources in order to make them useful for satisfying human wants. Some resources cannot be used directly. They have to be processed to make them useful for satisfying our wants. X. Land has to be cleared and plowed for growing crops. Water has to be taken to the field to irrigate. Map Natural Resources of India. Types of resources. On the basis of status of development. Potential resources, resources which are found in a region, but have not been utilized. Developed resources, resources which are surveyed and their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization. Stock, the resources which have potential to satisfy our needs but humans do not have appropriate technology to use them, are categorized under stock reserves. Reserves are the subset of the stock, which can be put into use with the help of existing technical know-how, but their use has not been started. Land as a resource. Land is the habitat of man. All the economic activities are performed on land. The soil cover on the land is essential for plant growth. So land is necessary for agriculture. Land is used to set up industrial units. Roads and railways are built on the land. Commercial activities also require land. Natural vegetation and wildlife are supported by land. Total land area of India is 3.28 million square kilometers. 43.41% of the land area is net zone area. Forests occupy 22.57% of land area. 6.29% of the land is wasteland. 7.92% of the land is used for non-agricultural purposes. 3.45% of the land is pastoral land. 1.10% of the land is tree crops. 4.41% of the land is cultivable waste. 3.82% of the land is fallow other than current fallow. 7.03% of the land is current fallow. Soil as a resource. The uppermost layer of the earth's crust, which is loose, broken and useful for plants, is called soil. Soil consists of mineral matter such as sand and clay and organic matter such as humus, bacteria and earthworms. Types of soil. Alluvial soil. Alluvial soil is the most fertile and widespread soil found in India. It is formed due to the deposition of fine silt called alluvium by the rivers. Black soil. Rigor soils are called black cotton soils because they are black in color and are very good for cotton cultivation. It is made up of extremely fine clayey materials. Red and yellow soil. Red and yellow soils are formed due to the weathering of crystalline igneous rocks under low rainfall conditions. It is found in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand. Ivy laterite soil. Laterite soil is formed due to intense leaching caused by tropical rainfall. Humus content is less because the microorganisms get destroyed due to high temperature. The arid soil. Arid soils are red or brown in color. They are sandy and saline. Humus and moisture contents are very less. They can be cultivated after irrigation. VI forest soil. Forest soils are found in hilly and mountainous regions. They are loamy and silted in valleys and coarse in the upper slopes. Images of alluvial soil and bulk soil. Images of red laterite arid and forest soils. Soil erosion. Removal of topsoil from one place to another by natural agencies is called soil erosion. It is caused by running water and wind. Deforestation, overgrazing and unscientific agricultural practices are responsible for large-scale soil erosion. Contour plowing reduces the flow of water and prevents soil erosion. In hilly areas, terraced farming should be followed. Strip farming helps to reduce the force of winds. Shelter belts of plants around the fields reduce soil erosion. Afforestation should be practiced on a large scale and deforestation should be stopped. Overgrazing by animals should be avoided. Video soil. Soil erosion, its impact and conservation.
We overlook it. We walk all over it. Trample it every day. Yet we need it, like the air we breathe. It's about time that we talk about soil, and certainly about time that we start protecting it. There can be no life without it. It feeds us, and we are responsible for it. Soil is formed from rocks that are decomposed slowly by the sun, the wind and the rain, by animals and plants. In this way, 10 centimeters of fertile soil are created in 2,000 long years, only 10 centimeters in 2 millennia. Soil that we deplete in only a few years, gone forever. Forests and plants protect the soil. But every year, 13 million hectares of forest are cut down. Fields are cultivated inadequately. Added to that are monocultures and farming on slopes. After the harvest, fields are left naked and unprotected. All this greatly accelerates erosion. And so, gone with the wind, washed away by water. 24 billion tons of fertile soil were lost in 2011 alone. A loss of 3.4 tons per person worldwide, no matter what age. Erosion costs each person $70 per year, a worldwide cost that amounts to $490 billion, an astronomical amount. Our cities are also growing rapidly. Every year in Europe, an area as large as the city of Berlin is transformed into urban areas. Half of these soils are sealed. This is soil from which nothing can grow. But fertile soil is finite and therefore invaluable. Investors and states have realized this. The race for the soils of the world has already begun. Land grabbing, often with questionable means for questionable purposes. Millions of hectares of land change owner every year. The price? Ruined lives, uprooted families. Usually, these are the poorest of the poor. Often they have no choice. They destroy the forest because they need land to survive. We need healthy and fertile soil, now more than ever. Projections say the available arable land per Earth inhabitant will be reduced by half by 2050. But already today, 1 billion people go to bed hungry night after night. That's 1 billion people too many, and this number will increase every day if we do not distribute soil fairly. If we do not increase yields dramatically on every piece of land, or simply discover a second earth, but we might not want to rely on that option. Soil and land issues rarely get our attention, or that of our policymakers. We see the full supermarket shelves and believe that things will stay like this forever. We live on credit at the expense of soils, but they are not inexhaustible. We take out money from a bank account into which we never make any deposits. One day, this account will be empty, our credit overdrawn, and our soils will be gone. But there is good news. We have long known what we must do in order to preserve soils for our children. Let's remember, soil is a sensitive living being who wants to be taken care of. It is not a factory. Everyone has a right to soil. This right must be safeguarded by the law. And we cannot afford to bury our livelihood under a layer of asphalt. Now, it's up to us. We must open our eyes and find ways to apply our knowledge, so we don't end up losing the ground under our feet.
Thanking to all our teachers, parents, and friends for motivating and supporting for making this beautiful project. This project has increased our knowledge. Thanking you all.